But anyway, this evening I have been reviewing some historicals. I'm like in a bit of a... Oh, it's a good one to kick you off your cloud if you were on a royal cloud. My Mary Williams, pioneer, true and true pioneer, married at 16 in Cave Valley. I did find a writing, a historical writing of hers. She's my great-great? Is she my great-great-grandmother? Something like that, yeah. I found a historical vital statistic history that she wrote later in her life, pretty much probably near the closer to the end. And it does detail, you know, where they went this way and where they went that way and where they moved. And it does have a little bit about the Pancho Villa thing. They left Mexico around 1912. It was called the Exodus, and then they returned in 1919. But along that time and the times before, it just sounds like it was just such a drudge, to live. I will try to find where I put the paraphrasing of it. I did write a little synopsis out of the history. I mean, I probably could have written the whole thing out, but I probably should have. Anyway, so what does it say here? I mean, in a way, she was humorous, but then I don't know. It just seemed like such a difficult life. I mean, here she's mentioning in this list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 children. Okay, so along this journey of her life, there are 9 children. So here she is married at 16 years old. She writes, she was born in New Washington, Washington, Arkansas. In 1871, December 8th. And noticing this also, that she wrote 8 December 1871, which is the European format they use still today. And this is the family, the Williams family is the one that they really became Ozarkian, but they were from France, and they lead into the Chastain family, and they do come from the French kings. Well, so it's kind of a funny line in a way, because they are so pioneer. Anyway, so we have here, she says she wrote an Arkansian, I guess that's how they say them. An Arkansian traveler that has traveled around most of my life, and still my children want me to keep traveling around hither and fro. Just a rolling stone that gathers no moss. And actually, I got that wrong. She's just a rolling stone. Just a rolling stone that has gathered no moss. So she says, has gathered no moss. She does use enough words, you know, sentence-wise. There is some education there. Some of these I've gone back to have been terrible. But this one is pretty good. She does use the word stuck, which is incorrect. But she does say, my life has been that of a pioneer. So she is intelligent enough to be able to write. And write a proper sentence as a female, and that's saying something, I guess. But, and I guess there was humor there, because there she is, just a rolling stone that has gathered no moss. And she she really did travel a lot. She was married in Salt Lake City. She's from Arkansas. They went down to Mexico mountains to live. Then they moved to Arizona. Her father died in Arizona. And all of that must have been just so terrible, because now we're so insulated. Our lives are so easy. We just can call the cremator on the phone or whatever. But there, I imagine you had to do it yourself. So all of these things, it's no big deal to cremate, but it does bring, I don't know, your happy humor notch goes a little bit out the window that day, that week. And I don't know. I mean, these women were tough. They were tough. They were coarse also. And that's not something that I admire. I don't admire any of their coarse. So this particular line, this Williams Arkansonian line from the French royals, is really an oddball. It's an oddball group. They are something else, though. She was dedicated to her history. She wasn't gonna just wimp out on it. She did write it, and they did have a honeymoon. I didn't really get to read about it, though. Something later happened, and it started just to become illegible. But it's very interesting. The dates are different. Her marriage dates are different from that, is what is listed on the family search. So a lot of things, maybe this is it, maybe this is the true marriage date, and the one that they have listed there is erroneous, So it could be I have the historical documents. So, I put some photos there of my mom, and that's kind of nice. It's kind of nice to put her there. She was such an elegant comedian in a way. Compared to this group, and my mom always made fun of this harsh pioneer group. Her grandmother, her great grandmother, she just made fun of them the whole time, that they just couldn't drop the act. Their life was such a chore. And she had one grandmother that was so mean. If she said one thing out of turn, she would put her down in the basement. She had to go down into the basement, and she shut the door. It was a trap door style. Yeah, they're mean women. And I don't know. I mean, maybe, life is hard. When you're out there on the plains, you're traveling around in covered wagons. You have Indians possibly going to kill you any moment. Maybe life was just very, very difficult. And they had to bake the breads, they had to make the food, this one had 9 children while this is all going on. You have to feed them, you have to try to get them somewhat educated there on your covered wagon, teach them a little bit of reading and writing. So they were everything, they were the teachers, they were the cooks, the menders. I mean, it was just a chore of a life. It was a chore of a life. So it's when I'm sitting here going, I have 150 kings, everybody, I you're not gonna see crowns the whole way from me to there. The saga, this 500 years in America has just been a harsh hit for a lot of us. A very harsh hit. It's good good I found the document. I found other things, though. I found my grandfather's birth record. He was born as Ricardo, which is a Spanish name. It's kind of humorous. So I found his original birth certificate. I found his original marriage certificate to my grandmother. And I found my great-grandfather's... what is that? His marriage certificate, I think. Yeah, so I found that all of these real important papers. So I feel kind of like, woo, Like I am like the genealogist who is has tapped back into the past, and I have all of the correct dates, you know. I'm probably uploading them wrong, putting them in the wrong place, and I right now I'm listing them as memories, and somebody's probably going to say, "No, you can't do that that way. It has to be online somewhere else. It's at Find a Grave or something." But I don't care. I'm putting them on those memories, and then I'm getting them out there, and then I'm listing them as a source, and maybe the whole thing gets updated better. Yeah, that's my big disappointment is they were such harsh women, and you know, in an odd way, she wanted to be a writer, you know. You know, what is that? A woman who would say such a thing? Just a rolling stone that has gathered no moss. Who would say such a thing? It's very odd. It's a very odd thing to have these. You know, she's making, what do you call it? Oh, I can't even think of it right now. She's making an analogy to her life. She's capable of doing that, so she's intelligent enough to make analogies. So it's kind of interesting, isn't it? She's referring to herself, though, as a stone. Her life has been that hard, that difficult. And here we are later in 1960s, you know, her life is a rolling stone, you know, coming out in the records, and here she is saying this back in the early times, you know. Anyway, so that was all. That's all I have. Lots of photos there for my mom, so that was great. I have more of her, and I can inundate, of course, but I'm trying to get selective ones. And still amazed at my grandmother and grandfather, their 50-year marriage. That is something else, huh? That's the Mormon Church, though. I really think that was quite a stability pusher in their life. That they would have no recourse but to be a 50-year marriage plus, you know. So anyway, folks, that's it. That's it. So Mary Williams, the tough, rough pioneer rolling stone. What a drag. Yeah, but I mean, imagine that, being in a covered wagon in Arizona. I think already. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. What a tough life.